Hello everyone. So we have discussed up till the, from lecture module lecture 1 to lecture 34, we have discussed all the theory concepts of the power electronics and instrumentation. So first I have completed the instrumentation part and then I come back to the power electronics then. So here also I am going to discuss about the what are the main similar problems which can be asked in the university question papers. So these are the similar questions which might be asked. The first one is the expected value of the voltages across a resistor is 80 volts. Measurement, to use a 80 volt measurement, use a value of 79 volts. So we are expecting a value of 80 volts and it gives a value of 79 volts. So what we have to find is the absolute error, percentage error, relative accuracy and percentage accuracy. So this is the unit 3 module 3 where we have discussed about the errors, the accuracy and all the related things there. So how to solve this problem? First we have to write what are the given things there. What is the expected values? Yn is equals to 80 volts, measured value is what? 79 volts. Yn is equals to 80 volts, Xn is equals to 79 volts. How to find an first one? Absolute error. So E is equals to expected value Yn minus measured value Xn, that is equals to 80 minus 79, that is equals to 1 volts. So that is the absolute error. If you want to find it in terms of a percentage, that is the B1, the percentage error is nothing but E, that is the absolute error divided by expected value into 100%. So what is the absolute error is 1 divided by 80, that's the expected value is 80 here, into 100%. So when I divided by 1 by 80 and multiplied into 100, that will give me 1.25%. so this is the 1.25% is of error. Next one is C, relative accuracy. What is A is equals to 1 minus the mod of Y of N minus X of N divided by Y of N. So this is the mod value. 1 minus Y of N minus X of N divided by Y of N. Y of N is the expected value, X of N is the measured value. So this we know, that is E, that is nothing but 1 divided by 80. So we don't get a negative value, so no is the mod there. So 1 by 80 is what? 1 minus 1 by 80 we have to do. That is what I do, did the cross multiplication, 80 minus 1 divided by 80, that is 79 by 80. When I divide, it is nothing but 0 is equals to 0.9875. That's the relative accuracy. When I go to the percentage accuracy, that is nothing but A is equals to capital A into 100%. Capital A into 100%. 0.9875 into 100%. That's again a simpler as one. It's nothing but 98.75%. So this is how solve one question on the errors. Next one. The table below gives the set of 10 measurements that were recorded in the laboratory. Some random experiment we can consider. So measurement 1, 2, up to 10 we have given. We have given a set of measured values. So it is nothing but X of N. 98, 101, 102, 97, 101, 100, 103, 98, 106, 99. So here we have a set of 10 values that were recorded in the lab for certain measurements, might be some measurement it is. So this is the, when it is taken 10 random values, we have got this values there. This is what the table means. This is nothing but How many times? The first time what you take, second time, third time, like that. If you take till 10 times, what are the values we have got? So these are the 10 values recorded, and we have to calculate the precision of the following measurement. We have to calculate the precision of the following measurement. But here one condition, they have not given the expected values. This is what we need to measure. So this is what in the precision we don't expect the expected value. We have different formula there. So we have to take a mean of it. That will go. So what they have asked, to find the precision of the sixth one, this one, then eighth one, then fourth one, then third one. Okay, this is nothing but represented by x of n. We'll go to the solution. What is the precision formula? Is that p is equals to 1 minus x of n minus x bar of n divided by x of n. What is x bar of n? Is nothing but average of all the 10 values divided by 10. How many values are there? Is 10, right? Divided by 10 values. So 98 plus 101 plus 102 plus 97 plus 101 plus 100 plus 103 plus 98 plus 106 plus 99 divided by 10. So that is nothing but 1005 divided by 10. If it is given 9 values here, so we have to make divide by 9. So here we got 10 values, we have to divide it by 10. So how it is there? So x bar of n is nothing but 100.5. So now we got the x bar of n, so we can calculate for the measured values. So first was for sixth reading, x of n was 100. 1 minus 100 minus 100.5 divided by 100.5. So this is the thing. So what is that we are getting? So here we need the mod value, because 100 minus 100.5 is nothing but minus 0.5. So we can discard it, and we got it 0.5 minus, minus value has been discarded here, 0.5 divided by 100.5. So that is 100.5 minus 0.5 divided by 100.5. So that time it will come 100 divided by 100.5. So precision is nothing but 0.995. Next one, similarly for the 8th reading. So what is the x of n? 98. Similarly, p is equals to 1 minus the mod of 98 minus 100.5 divided by 100.5. Similarly, 1 minus 2.5 divided by 100.5. So minus is been ignored. So that is given by what it will become? 100.5 minus 2.5. So it is nothing but 98 divided by 100.5 will come. So again, when we divide it, we get p is equals to 0.9751. So it is telling that 97.51% of precise value it is. For fourth reading, x of n is equals to 97. That is, p is equals to 1 minus x of n is 97 minus 100.5 divided by 100.5. So 1 minus mod of minus 3.5 divided by 100.5. So that is given. So 100.5 minus 3.5 is nothing but again 97 divided by 100.5. So again the precision is equals to 0.9652. So what does that mean? It is having 96.52% of precision values. Now next one, third one. X of n is equals to 102. That is, p is equals to 1 minus 102 minus 100.5 divided by 100.5. This is what it is there. 1 minus, again it will, here x of n is greater than this x of n. X of n is greater than x bar of n here. So it will get a positive value, that is a 1.5 divided by 100.5. That is 100.5 minus 1.5. So it will come 99.100.5. 5. So it is almost equals to 0.9851. That is what? Almost 98.51% of precision. Okay. This is how we need to solve problems when for the precision has been given. Next one. A voltmeter having sensitivity of 1 kilo ohm per volt, that is for 1 kilo ohm of resistance per volt, is connected across an unknown resistance in series with a milliammeter reading 80 volt on 150 volt scale. So this is what a 0 to 150 volt scale it is there, but it's having a reading showing in the milliammeter is a 80 volt. When the milliammeter reads 10 milliamps, the calculate, we have to calculate all these values. Apparent resistance of unknown resistance, then actual resistance of unknown resistance, error due to the loading effect of the voltmeter. So now, we need to calculate total current circuit resistance. So that is RT is equals to VT divided by IT. RT is equals to VT divided by IT. The simple way to calculate. V we know, I we know here. So what is we are getting in the reading of the voltmeter is 80 volts divided by what we are getting when 80 volt on the voltmeter. We are getting a milliammeter as 10 milliamps. So when we calculate it, the resistance is 8 kilo ohm of the total resistance of the circuit. But one thing, we have neglected the internal resistance of the milliammeter. Okay, if they have mentioned to whatever the milliammeter with the internal resistance of so and so. So that time RT is equals to VT divided by IT minus RM. This minus RM we have to consider. So here they are not given, so we can neglect those things. Now, what is the actual resistance of the unknown resistance? So that is, we have to calculate there. We have to calculate with respect to the RV is equals to S into V minus RM. S is nothing but sensitivity into voltage minus RM. Minus RM. But what is sensitivity? Is nothing but 1 divided by IFST, that is a full scale reading. That is the one full scale reading. Okay. Then what is that? S is what? Sensitivity. They have given sensitivity as 1 kilo ohm per volt. So that is nothing but S. This is nothing but S. But one question will come. What is this V? V is nothing but the scale at which it is working. So that is 1000 into 150 is what we are S into V. 1000 into 150, that is 1000 is nothing but 1 kilo. Okay. So this 150 is this voltage scale, so that is S into V minus RM. But as I mentioned earlier, we don't have not mentioned the internal resistance, so I am considering RM as 0. So what is this? Nothing but RV is equals to 150 kilo ohm. 150 kilo ohm. Next, we have to calculate the actual value of the unknown resistance. So no, so that time 1 by Rx is equals to 1 by Rt minus 1 by Rp. Why we have taken it into the inverse? Because they are connected in parallel here. The voltmeter, everything has been connected in parallel. Now, what is that unknown resistance might be? Rx. So that is when I multiply Rt into Rv divided by Rv minus Rt. Or we can say it like this way. Okay. That is the 1 by Rx is nothing but total resistance minus the known apparent resistance here. This is 1 by Rt minus 1 by Rb. So this is what I am telling. We can say in other words that apparent resistance plus actual resistance is equals to the total resistance. The apparent resistance is nothing but the concept that the due to the that voltmeter sensitivity factors there. These are the due to the apparent resistance here. Okay, so total resistance minus apparent resistance should give me the actual value. So for that purpose, I have calculated this one like this way, and they are connected in parallel. So for that purpose, I am doing like this way. So Rx is equals to RT into RV when I multiply RV minus RT. When I substitute RT, 8 kilo, RV is nothing but 150 kilo. So divided by 150 kilo minus 8 kilo. So that time, when I calculate this one, I am getting 8.45 kilo ohms. 8.45 kilo ohms. So what is now, we can observe here. So actual value is what? 8.4 kilo ohm. And what we were getting is the 8 ohm. So we have to calculate with respect to the apparent value. Okay, this is the apparent resistance, apparent total resistance what we have to be calculate. So that is what does C, the error due to the loading effect, how the value has been changed. So actual value is what? 8.45 kilo minus apparent value. So that is nothing but RT value, what I am considering, that is 8 kilo ohm divided by actual 8.45 kilo into 100. So when I calculate this one, that is nothing but 5.3%. So simple logic here is the apparent is due to the direct voltage and the current factor without considering the sensitivity other thing. But here in the ammeters and the voltmeter, we need to consider this factor, the sensitivity and the loading effect due to the what we are measuring across the loads and all. So that has to be considered. So that I need to calculate with respect to the actual value. And one more thing is that the voltmeter resistance has to be considered. That is nothing but RV here. So how this RV has been calculated with respect to the sensitivity factor and due to the full scale value. So on that basis, I have to be considered. But I cannot assure this is also exact value because they have not mentioned the internal resistance. So every multimeter or a voltmeter will have its internal resistance. So this is just an approximation analysis. Okay. Next one. A 1 millimeter movement having an internal resistance of a 100 ohm is used to convert into a multi-range ammeter having the range 0 minus 100 milliamp. One range, another range 0 to 20 milliamp, another 0 to 50 milliamp. Determine the value of the shunt resistance required. So what they have given? IM. What is that? 1 millimeter meter movement. And they have mentioned here the internal resistance RM is equals to 100 ohms. So we have to find shunt resistance for required for different ranges 0 to 100, 0 to 10, 0 to 20 and 0 to 50 milliamps. So RS shunt 1, I will consider it for this first range 0 to 10 milliamp RS shunt 1, the shunt resistance 1 that I even calculated by IM into RM divided by I minus IM. So IM you know 1 millimeter, that's a meter movement, and that is RM we know that's at 100. What is this I? Is this from which range has to be calculated? That is we call as the I. 10 milliamps minus 1 milliamp, that is the I. When I calculate this value, I'll get it as 11.11. So we cannot say 11.11, we can say 11.11 ohms. Similarly, when we consider it for 0 to 20 milliamp, so that time RSH2, I denote it as, that is IM into RM divided by I minus IM. So IM into RM is same, 1 milliamps into 100 divided by I is nothing but 20 milli minus 1 milli. That time I can consider as a 5.26 ohm. Only the factor has been changing is this 20 because I is nothing but here. So always remember this formula, this is the same always. Here also you can observe it. Okay. Let me finish this one. So what you call next is for 0 to 50 milliamp. So RSH3 is equals to Im into Rm divided by I minus Im 1 milli into 100 divided by 50 milli minus 1 milli. So again, this 50 milli is what? The same thing. Okay. Right. That's, if we calculate this value, it will come in terms of a 2.041 ohms. So always remember, this value is nothing but I, and rest all will be given there, same thing. But this is for which one? This is to find the shunt resistor for a milliammeter, okay, for a multi-ring ammeter. Now we'll see next problem, that is the a diazonal movement with a full scale deflection current of 50 milliamp and internal resistance of 500 ohm is to be converted into a multi-range voltmeter. Determine the value of multiplier required for 0 to 20 volts, 0 to 20 volts, and 0 to 50 volts, and 0 to 100 volts. So what they are given, they have a need to find a diazonal moment has been there in the FST. It's a full scale distinction with a current of 550 microamp and internal resistance of 500 ohm. So it has to be converted into multi-range voltmeter. So which has that? The range of 0 to 20, 0 to 50, and 0 to 100. This is also similar like previous problem, but the formula has been changed. Just the same thing, you can observe it here. So what they have given, Im is equal to 50 microamps. Rm, they have given internal resistance of 500 ohms. The range is equals to what they have given, 0 to 20, first one. That is Rs is equals to V divided by Im, V divided by Im minus Rm. So whatever this V is nothing but this range here, of which range has to be designed. Similarly here also. So V is equals to 20, Im is 50 micro minus 500. So when I substitute and get the values, so 399.5 kilohms will be get. Then a range of 0 to 50 volts, V is nothing but 50 divided by Im, that is the 50 micro minus Rm. Rm, again the same thing, only the value has been changing is the V minus Rm. Rm is what? 40, 500. So that is 999.5 kilo ohms. So one more range is there, that is the thing. So similar here, you can observe it here, this V is nothing but again the 100. So Rs is equals to V divided by Im minus Rm. V divided by Im minus Rm is equals to 100 divided by 50 micro, 100 divided by 50 micro minus 500, that is nothing but 139.5 kilo ohm. Okay, so this is how we need to calculate it for voltmeter. Now one more problem here. Convert a basic diazonal movement with an internal resistance of 100 ohms and a full scale deflection of 10 milliamp into a multi-range DC voltmeter. This is what? A DC voltmeter with a voltmeter ranges from 0 to 5 volts, 0 to 50 volts, and 0 to 100 volts. So they have given it as a deflection of 10 milliamp, Rm is equals to 100 ohms. Im is equals to 10 milliamps, Rm is equals to 100 ohms. So we can look it into the circuits here, that is the how this has to be converted into DC voltmeter. This has a deflection like this, V3, V2, V1. So V3 when connected, R3 plus Rm, like this will flow. With we change the voltmeter, again the R2 plus R3 plus Rm. Then again we need to increase the voltage, that is R1 plus R2 plus R3 plus Rm. So like that we need to find. So what is that first one? For range of V3, what is happening here? That is for 5 volts. RT is equals to V divided by IFST, that is equals to F5 divided by 10 milliamps. Why they say it is nothing but IFST and IM are same. Okay, that is here IM and IFST is same. IFSD is same. That is the full scale deflection. Okay, the both are same here. IM is equals to IFSD. So both are same here. So that is equals to 0.5 kilo ohms. 5 divided by 10 in 10 milli is equals to 0.5 kilo ohms. R3 is equals to, why this one? This is what we are getting with respect to this resistance. This we have got the total resistance here. But what is actually R3? What is the value of R3? So that I am getting the 5 volts. So RT we know, that is what? We 0.5 minus Rm, that is what? 100. That is 400 ohms. That is RT minus Rm is nothing but, what is that? 0.5, that is 500 ohms minus 100 ohms, that is 400 ohms. Next one is the 50 volts, that is the V2. RT is equals to V divided by IFST. V divided by IFST. Okay, what is this V value? That is the 50 divided by 10 milliamps. This value will be same here for all the things. Okay, this is the 10 milliamps is the full scale reading, and this, what is there? We need to calculate the voltage value here, because this voltage value will tell the what is the full scale deflection of this one. So again, when you substitute it here, so similarly here, when you substitute this one and here also says the same thing. We need to substitute it here. 550 divided by 10 milliamps is nothing but 5 kilo. So now R2 is what? RT minus R3 plus Rm, the previous resistance plus Rm. Previous value is R3 is 400. Okay, what was the previous value then? It was R3 was 400 ohms. 400 plus Rm value is 100, that is what? 500 ohms. So 5 kilo ohm minus 500 ohm is nothing but 4.5 kilo ohm. The step 3 is for 100 volts. The same thing, RT is equals to V divided by IFST, that is 100 divided by 10 milliamp is equals to 10 kilo ohms. So that is R1 is equals to RT minus, R1 is equals to RT minus R2, that is the 4.5 kilo ohm. Plus R3 is 400 ohms plus 100 ohms. So 10 kilo minus 4.5 plus 400 ohms plus 100. So it will become 5 kilo ohms. So 10 kilo ohm minus 5 kilo ohms is nothing but 5 kilo ohms. So this is how we need to solve with respect to the, when they have to given the DC voltmeter. So here three problems will come. In direction moment, we have a two more problems. That direction moment usually will be for voltmeters there, and that is if it is a normal multi-range voltmeter, we have to follow the previous method. If they ask you for the DC voltmeter, then you have to follow this one, because we need to calculate each value, and that has to be added to like this way, this formula. Then one more problem on the multi-range ammeter 3. Then one more, the sensitivity valve problem, that is we have to find the apparent resistance and the actual resistance. The problems on precision, then for the problem on the precision, then the problem on the errors, problem on precision and errors. So total we have the six type of different problem that will be required for understanding the theory part, and we need to read the theory part and then we have to solve this problem. That will be useful for you. Before understanding the theory, you can't solve this problem. Okay. So whatever the problem have been taken as from HS Kelsey, the electronic instrumentation, that is as per prescribed VTU test book there. So other two are some references, some problem might have taken there. Okay. So just another two or three similar problems have been there in the HS Kelsey. You can refer those things and it will be useful to understand. Again, you have a practice of this thing. Okay, thank you.